French accent comes in all shapes and sounds. How can you sound a little bit less like an English speaker and a little bit more like a Parisian? I know this is something you've been looking for. So let's dive in. The main benefit of trying to improve your accent is actually in your mind. Before I get to the concrete steps of what you can do to improve your French accent, let me remind you that it is difficult to learn and to speak in a foreign language without feeling too self-conscious. I am self-conscious about my English. However, if you concentrate on doing a French accent, then it becomes kind of a game. You are playing and you will be practicing more and improving more. That's a good thing. It's a bit like another practice that I usually recommend to my students, which is parler à son chien en français, talking to your dog in French. Yes, it works with your cat as well. The idea is to practice your French so you can improve without being so self-conscious about yourself. And it works! Now, the first step to getting a Parisian accent is the pronunciation. For example, mastering the nasal sounds. The on, the en, the un. Remember, the on, the en, the un. Yes, these are tricky. There are the basic nasal sounds that we have in French. They appear with different spellings as well, because you have some with the A, some with the U as well. And a trick is that when there is no liaison involved behind those sounds, there is no N in the sound. It's just on, en, un. I know that nasal sounds are difficult for an English speaker because they're very hard to differentiate. But to a French ear, they're very different. For instance, we have marron, marron, marin. These are very different. Marron means funny, marron means brown, and marin means a sailor. You should be able to hear the difference and to pronunciate them properly if you want to join a French conversation. This is really going to help you. Similarly, the OU and the U don't sound the same. We also have the E and the E, which are different. And also even O and A. Why are those so important? Because deux canards font le mur, two ducks are escaping. Deux canards font le mur is not the same as deux connards font l'amour. Some assholes are making love. Deux connards font l'amour. No. Of course, you can get by with the context and the body language when you're joining a conversation or if you're watching a movie or a TV show. But you will get so much more confident once you master these sounds. That's a very good first step to get a French accent. I will tell you more about this at the end of this video. Of course, this is the difficult stuff up front, but at Commune Française, I'd rather tell you what really matters to French people when they're listening to you speak French, rather than just giving the easy tricks that don't really make a difference. For example, there's some shortcuts to get you the French accent. The main things usually are the French R that you can hear in marron, marron, marin, marin, marron, marron, this French R from the back of the throat. I did a whole video on this and I will tell you more at the end of this video as well. The other one is stressing the end of the words in French. This one is far more subtle. In French, we mostly stress the end of the word, so the last syllable. For example, with an ananas, a pineapple, we don't say an ananas. We don't say an ananas, we say an ananas. We stress the last syllable. Okay, about the stressing of the last syllable, I know that some people are going to pick it up immediately, others won't be able to get it, and that's fine. In English, I don't get it. I gave up on the right stressing of the right syllable in English because my brain doesn't compute it at all. So it's fine if you don't get this point. And this is very important. There are some elements that you can just give up on and that's fine. I know that lots of students stress about the French R. This is what I should work on. Geraldine, how can I improve this? But it doesn't matter at all, because most of the time this is going to constitute your accent, which is very cute. Just like some people love the French people speaking English, we love foreigners speaking French, and the accent they have is wonderful. So just keep it and embrace it.
Rejoignez-moi sur le nouveau site de premier.fr.
You'd better practice your nasal sounds, for example. This is not going to give you the full French accent as you see everywhere, but it is going to help you understand everything much better and be able to speak without being self-conscious about saying accidentally a big insult to a waiter. And by the way, is there really a French accent? What we call the French accent is actually the Parisian accent, the one that we hear mostly in the media and also in most of the government as well. And it's mine too. But exactly like English speakers come with accents, there are many ways to speak French even in France. People speak with a different accent in the south.
Moi, je suis fière de mon accent, je vais pas le gommer, je vais pas... Non. On est dans le sud, on parle du sud et puis c'est tout.
And it's even a different one in the southwest.
Il prononcera toutes les syllabes, il ne roulera plus le R, comme le disait Nougaro dans la fameuse chanson de Toulouse.
Let alone the northern part of France.
Touché, tcho, jeunes, ils sont venus ici.
And of course, French territories overseas all have their own accent.
Les transporteurs sanitaires, un métier passionnant mais très peu reconnu, comme Jeannot Ayho que nous avons suivi à Papéari.
The French language became synonymous with the French accent, as with the centuries, French basically colonized itself, especially after the Industrial Revolution. The flattening of accents even applies to Paris itself, which used to have different kinds of accents in the different neighborhoods. Nowadays, of course, other French accents stay especially strong outside of the French borders, like in Belgium.
Non, je n'ai rien su fait. J'ai tâché de courir derrière. Qu'est-ce que tu veux faire? Non, avec ma veste en cuir dedans, avec les 70 000 balles dedans. Non, je suis écœuré. Non, t'as lunettes, qu'est-ce que tu veux, mom?
Or in Québec, French Canada.
Je pense que le français, c'est vraiment le ciment à Montréal de la culture. Partout où on va, dans les commerces, dans les rues.
And in Africa as well, like in Sénégal.
C'est le fleuve Sénégal, long de 1750 km et 500 mètres de large. Il prend sa source dans les régions montagneuses au foot de Long en République de Guinée.
All these accents have their own pronunciation, their own vocabulary, and even their own grammar. You can't get fluent in all these accents, so as I said, you only need to get confident speaking French with your own accent, whatever it is. You can start by improving your pronunciation of the French nasal sound, then you can work on hearing the difference between the U sound and the O sound, and yes, if you want, feel free to work on your French R. Yes, that's tricky. I prepared a playlist with all these lessons for you. It's just right here. Click on your screen to access those lessons and I will see you there. Allez, à tout de suite.